It was the era that saw Jessica Alba tearing up dance floors and Julia Stiles tearing up tabletops. And one man screaming all over your favourite R&B tracks. It was the early noughties, and if you wanted an R&B smash hit, it simply had to feature Fatman Scoop, as proven by Missy Elliott, Ciara and Mariah Carey. Now, Scoop's driving the old-school R&B train down under as part of the Friday's live lineup featuring Macklemore, TLC, Akon and Craig David.
Thank you, and you, and you too, sir. That's like the story of my life.
Yeah.
Like, condensed.
Flash before your eyes.
Yeah.
Amazing.
That's
hey, beautiful. So great to have you on the desk again.
Thank you, man.
Are we going with Fatman or Scoop? What am I meant to call you?
Fatman.
Fatman?
Yeah, I mean, I won't. No, because I.
Hang
Scoop,
on, hang
just
on.
Go with very... Scoop, sir.
Scoop.
I'm all over the place.
Yeah, you really did a 180
there. Listen, I just got here 10 hours ago. Like,
oh, wow.
Give me a break.
Oh, wow.
My brain's a scramble.
How was the trip, Mr. Scoop?
Oh, man. You know, when you fly from New York to Australia, it doesn't matter what class of flight you're in. I happen to be in business class. No matter what, you're going to be shell-shocked. So I probably am going to retain about 2% of what you're saying.
Yeah.
So just work with me.
Okay, well, I am going to reflect on something that you did the last time that you were here, which was being the hype man for Friday's Live. And on that
yes.
particular tour, you were with Janet Jackson, mm-hmm. 50 Cent, Black Eyed Peas.
Yep.
It sounds like a big party. Was it?
Huge.
Huge?
And the funny thing is that a lot of these people, I know them, but I never get a chance to work with them. So I did a record with Janet Jackson, however, I had never met Janet Jackson. So even a guy like me had done a record, I was like, oh man, that's Janet Jackson, damn. Look at that, woo! Now, I shouldn't have said woo, I shouldn't have been looking at certain body parts, but I was. I'm a man, what do you want from me? It's like you were looking at the Tommy Lee. I know both of you guys. Both of you probably looked at it more than once. You look like you looked at it four times.
Have we met?
How many times have you checked out the Tommy Lee's Instagram page?
It's like I just saw it in the back,
yep.
and I can't unsee it. It's almost like, remember when Apple gave you the U2 album?
Yeah.
And like you didn't want it, it just came, it was just there? And that's the way it is. It's like, I didn't need that.
No, yeah. That was the most perfect analogy.
You wanted it.
Did I?
We should have heard her in the rehearsal. She was like, well, I work on the news. I have to know.
It's like me
reporting on big booties.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm a lover of big booties, yeah, so I'm yep, black. Yep. I don't know about you.
I've got a big booty myself,
no, no, sir.
Got,
yeah. Not your booty, sir. We're talking about women here. So if there was a big booty to report on, it's the news. I have to see this.
You would rather become a journalist.
If your penis is pixelated, you should see a doctor. This day.
I'm good.
As a professional hype man, I'm fascinated.
Yes,
through a pandemic, there's been lockdowns. Does that mean your job became more important? How do you hype on Zoom?
You know something? My job became non-existent in an instant. So I was on the road with Shaggy, Nelly, and a couple other people, and we had one last show. And then after that, it was over. So I learned, it was very important, the lesson that I learned. You have to have more than one stream of income. So I went into the trucking business. I'm doing some things in the cannabis business. I was lucky. I paid my ex-wife off in the pandemic. I got her out of the way. So I am moving into different things. So not only will I be a hype man, I have a cannabis company, a trucking company, an ice cream company. And even though it was a disaster, it was a blessing because it taught me so much. You can't depend on one thing. If you eat the one thing, you're gonna starve at the same time if it goes away. And my thing, I implore everybody out here to get more than one stream of income, because if you don't, you're dangerously close to just your entire thing being over.
Wow. Julie bakes cookies. You should get together, I think.
I'm picturing a cannabis ice cream truck.
Yeah, right, they all work.
You must must have gone through tough times then.
Tough is not even the word.
Yeah, so how do you, who puts out so much positivity, where do you find the positivity?
Oh, man, listen, that destroyed my entire life. Imagine making X amount of $1,000 a month to zero and sitting in your house and having no purpose. So what you have to do, you have to find a new purpose. Again, it was a blessing for me because if I didn't go through that, maybe I wouldn't be involved in any of these other businesses. Ooh. So you almost have to take lemons and make it lemonade. But let me tell you something, that hurt. There were days that I didn't know what was going to happen next. Look, I don't even know what's happening next. What's happening tomorrow? But you just have to get up, stand up, and keep going. And what you have to do is learn the art of the pivot. So I went and started doing my own Instagram TV show. And I built that up, and I got my social media together, and I did it. And listen,
Tommy Lee had some ideas, by the way.
It's still in my mind.
So sorry.
But you take what you have and you make something. I also got some assistance from the government because I'm a business owner. But the bigger picture is, and I got lucky because I had a business. What about the average man? We got, we didn't get a lot of money for the average man. Because I had a business, I was able to, get funding and stuff. But you have to get up and keep pushing and keep working. The people who win, get up and continue to work.
That's right.
Hey, we're running out of time, but I've got to ask you about something that happened last time you were here. Our Prime Minister at the time was... But do you remember what
happened? Very different now, doesn't he?
Do you remember what happened? Because he put a tweet out, had your song in
Listen,
it.
That was huge, right? But here's my problem now. Yeah. I have nobody if I need help in immigration. Nobody in the church where I got to turn to Joe Niemeyer or Andy Purcell over there at Frontier Touring.
But and your Prime Minister's the next DJ, so you might be all right.
Yeah.
What?
Yes. Yeah, he does DJ.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it's true. Yeah.
Can we make a remix? Or something?
Oh,
sure.
Here's the thing. I need help because anytime I come here, what if I do something wrong? I need something.
Do you know what? With your cannabis business, I reckon you can find a way through.
Do you have his number? Do you have guy's number?
Which guy? The new Prime Minister's number? I'm a bit worried if I share that number with you. I don't know what's going to happen.